From what this mystery sound is to what it could mean in general and for all of mankind, join me as we explore the mysterious fast radio burst, FRB signal, from another galaxy that is repeating every 16 days. In space, no one can hear you scream, right? Well, that may or may not be true. Mythbusters actually tested this as a matter of fact. But the real truth is that in space, there are tons of sounds for us to listen to and to observe and potentially understand. We have recorded the sounds of the sun, of various planets, and occasionally, outer space sends us a signal that we call a fast radio burst, or FRB, that rings out, and we have to discover what it is and what caused it to be formed. FRBs are hugely energetic flares of radiation in the radio spectrum that last just a few milliseconds at most. In that time frame, they can discharge as much power as hundreds of millions of suns. This kind of science is very intriguing and very important because of how it helps us understand space as a whole. But the catch is this: these FRBs are meant to be very fast and very singular in their message, meaning that the message that they deliver throughout the stars is not repeated. It happens, and then it's gone. That's what makes it so much of a mystery at times, because we have to figure out what series of events led to that sound. Occasionally, there will be a signal that is found that sometimes repeats, but never is it regular. It just never happened until, for the first time, astronomers have found a fast radio burst, FRB, that repeats on a regular cycle. Every 16.35 days, the signal named FRB180916.J0158+65 follows a similar pattern. For 4 days, it will spit out a burst or two every hour. Then it falls silent for 12 days. Then the whole thing repeats. Astronomers with the Canadian Hydrogen Intensity Mapping Experiment, CHIME, collaboration in Canada, observe this cycle for a total of 409 days. We don't know yet what it means, but it could be another piece in the complicated conundrum of FRBs. Complicated indeed, because certainly this has never happened before. Last year, the CHIME collaboration announced they had detecting a whopping 8 new repeating fast radio bursts, bringing the then total of repeaters to 10 out of over 150 FRB sources. And as of now, that's been up to 11. But even then, 11 out of 150 of these signals being repeated in some way, and then one and only one being repeated regularly and in a real timetable, that's just weird. And it's got a lot of people scratching their heads as to why this can happen and how it happens. But that's the thing though, because this particular signal is a repeater that has a timeline that means it can be further studied. The discovery of a 16.35-day periodicity in a repeating FRB source is an important clue to the nature of this object, the researchers wrote in their paper. Think about it. If it is repeating like clockwork, that means there's a series of events going on that is causing the signal to happen at a regular frequency. This could be the work of galactic objects or something going on with a nearby star. But there are some who even speculate that black holes could be a major player in all of this. But it's still a bit unclear. However, there are a few things working in the favor of those who are trying to figure this out. FRB180916.J0158+65 is one of the handful of FRBs that have been traced back to a galaxy. It's on the outskirts of a spiral galaxy 500 million light years away, in a star-forming region. This means a supermassive black hole is unlikely, but a stellar mass black hole is possible. Black holes are still very much a mystery to us in regards to their power, which is massive and can destroy about everything, their cores, and all the effects they have on objects. Given that things about them are still being learned, it is possible that this signal is nothing more than a byproduct of its natural life, or even the potential nearby stars' natural lives. The single constraint on the orbital period still allows several orders of magnitude range in companion mass amongst known stellar mass compact object binaries, from so-called black widow binary systems consisting of a low-mass star and a powerful millisecond pulsar whose wind ablates the companion, albeit typically with few-hour orbital periods, to massive FRB stars with highly eccentric companion pulsar orbits, the researchers wrote. But that doesn't mean the opposite also couldn't be true. Before we continue diving into all of this signal and other business, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. That way you don't miss any of our weekly videos. This is the major problem with FRBs. There's just too much we don't know about where they came from, what they are doing, and why they are doing things at the rate they are, or even the rate they aren't going on. What makes some of them repeat and some of them not? What really is the difference between all the FRBs? Or is there any at all? Well, we might have a small clue on that front, but it may not be what you expect it to be. Do you remember that 11th repeater I mentioned earlier? It was found coming from an FRB astronomers had thought was a one-off. Its repeats were simply too faint for the equipment that had initially been used to look for them, which, believe it or not, is a common problem with our researching the stars, as we sometimes have the means to look at the stars or observe them and other objects in certain ways, but rarely can we do a deep dive like many want to. Getting back on track, this suggests that many more FRBs could be repeating, but outside our detection range. And the fact that FRB 180916.J0158+65 seem more or less the same as other FRBs could mean that other repeating FRBs are also on a cycle. We just haven't detected those cycles yet. Future observations, both intensity and polarimetric and at all wave bands, could distinguish among models and are strongly encouraged, the researchers wrote, as their searches for periodicities in other repeaters to see if the phenomenon is generic. And that's what scientists are going to do. They're going to keep looking at this signal and more to see what else pops up. And if any clues arise about what it truly might be, whether it be something generic, something special, or something else in between. So what does this say about our universe as a whole? Well, simply put, there are still lots of things about our universe that we don't know, don't understand, and are unlikely to understand at this point in time, and likely in the immediate future. After all, with many of these FRBs being light years upon light years away, we're already playing a game of catch-up in regards to how we're finding out about these signals, and trying to determine what they are all about. Don't forget, FRB 180916.J0158+65 had to be studied for hundreds of days to determine that it was a real repeating signal. And that was just one true fact that we found out about it. Everything else that surrounds it, not so much. Now, I'm sure some of you are stating the following. Well, since it's repeatable, doesn't that mean that it's something non-natural? You know, that it comes from aliens? Usually this would be the point where someone would mock you because of that notion, but not here. The alien question is a sound one, and it's one that many have put to the test when it came to these many FRBs, and especially FRB 180916.J0158+65. After all, it's very true that with the repeatable nature of this signal, that it would seem to indicate that it would be something constructed and repeated by someone or something. Here's the thing though, while they were researching this signal and plotting them out, they noticed that every single signal was different. Which does not discount alien life for the record, but the fact that these signals have no similarities between them at all, and yet all feel the same in their length, outside of the signal we're focusing on today, seem to indicate that these are indeed natural occurrences. After all, if this was an alien signal, why would it be going on for only a few milliseconds? Not to mention, why wouldn't it repeat? Only 10 of these FRB signals have ever repeated, but it wasn't in a pattern-like setting in the way that FRB 180916.J0158+65 did. So for an alien species to do something like that would either be very primitive or very dumb. Or of course, it could be in an advanced way of communicating that we don't understand, but at present it doesn't seem that way. As for FRB 180916.J0158+65, it would be fair to say that its repeating pattern would indicate a signal from an advanced society that can send signals into space. But that raises the question of, why only once every 16 days? Well, that is a pattern that doesn't seem to be one that would be done by a society. Sure, it could be that because their place in the galaxy that they're in, we're not receiving all the signals, or that the ones that reach us are the ones that are made every 16 days for various reasons, but based on the observations of the signal, they seem too basic to be alien communications. To be clear, this does not prove that aliens don't exist. It's just that when it comes to this particular anomaly in space, it doesn't add up to it being aliens, at least not this time. Which brings us back to the belief that it is a natural sequence of objects that are causing these events to happen. Notice that I said the word belief and not theory, because when it comes to these FRBs, we honestly don't have a lot of theories that match up with the signals we're getting in space. Even FRB 180916.J0158+65 has a lack of theories surrounding it because there's just not a lot to go on. The few things we can guess about it in terms of the natural events that cause it to make up these radio signals is that something is blocking it for 16 days, and then it opens up for a period of time before it being blocked again for another 16 some odd days. Does this sound something familiar to you? It should, because it sounds like an orbit. If the signal is, say, coming from a planet for one reason or another, again, not aliens this time, and its orbit around the star or stars that it's around makes it blocked out for a period of 16 days, and then able to get free enough to make the signals, that would give us a lot of clues as to why the signals only reach out during those points, including possibly telling us why the stars are affecting that planet in such a way. Or if this is another celestial object like a star causing the signal, like a neutron star, a pulsar, or a black hole, if we can single out why it only happens in certain bursts, or even why it's happening at all. But even with the longer and repeating frequencies, if it doesn't happen enough or in a way that we can't examine them, we're kind of helpless in terms of trying to figure out what is going on with them and why they are happening at all. Perhaps the biggest mystery of all of these is why they happen in scattered parts of the universe and why they don't last very long. What could make this happen all over, yet not be the same as others, and still only last a short time? No one really has the answer to this. Which brings us to an interesting point that no one can technically dispute. What if the reason we don't know what these signals really are, or where they came from, is because they're from something in the universe that we don't fully understand yet? I know this may seem like a cop-out answer, but you need to realize that when it comes to the universe of ours, we know a lot less than we think. What's more, we've proven time and time again that every time we think we know something, it's only because we forced ourselves to understand it. A great example is the recent discoveries of more moons on Jupiter and Saturn. How in the heck do we miss those when they're in our own solar system? It's because we can't keep an eye on space all the time, and that means there's things out there that we don't fully get. A great example of this is neutron stars or pulsars or even black holes. At one point in time, scientists didn't know or understand how these things work or what they even were. And it took time and effort and energy and research to figure it all out. If it took them that long to figure out that which is common knowledge now, how long might it take to figure out these radio signals? The universe is vast and it doesn't give up answers that easily, which is why so many people are trying to solve its mysteries. And this is just the latest one of the bunch. Thanks for watching, everyone. What do you think about these mysterious, fast radio bursts and the new one that has a repeating pattern? Do you think that the mystery of what they are and how they're created will be solved soon? Or do you think it'll take a while before we figure it out? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.